Folks, heading to expedition number 55. It's going to be a wild ride. Strap on your boots and let's head out in the field. All right, folks, so we're gonna at the first stop here, and got Devin here, and we're going to go check the camera out here over in the Allegheny State Park. This is where we had the sighting of the gray Bigfoot. All right, moving up through. Pretty quiet up here. Up. Whoa, look at that. Right here. Something big's been in there. Yeah, it could have been. You're right, Devin, it could have been. All right. All right, it's recording.
There we go.
All right, turn this off.
Is it good?
It's good. Yeah, it's
about check out the camera. We're gonna stand here for like 2 minutes, see if we get any responses of anything. We're gonna head up to Indian Pipeline.
Okay, folks, so what we're doing right now is holding off here a second. We're gonna get going, and I'm gonna set up a trail camera that I have on my back here, and it's gonna be covering our back door, and hopefully that we get some activity going. I have this anomaly detector. They say it detects ghosts or whatever, but I was reading it, and some people have said that it does a really good job on detecting spirits than aliens. The reason why I'm curious on this is because I have had some incidents where I've seen invisible type anomalies. I don't know what they are, but I don't see anything in this area, so let's get ready to roll. What do you think, Devin? Think we'll see any squatches today, buddy? Yeah, it's really quiet, though, so that's a good thing. Well, we'll see if it's...
Yeah, we'll take a straight shot and see if we get any some calls, some knocks.
Yeah, folks, so we're still working our way up this trail. Let's see what kind of activity we get on here. So we're working our way up a little bit. It's really quiet, so if we're going to hear something, we're going to hear something. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. So, let's move up. So look at this, folks. Looks like something... It's going through there. Like right through here. But there's no tracks here. Around through there, see that? Looks like, kind of looks like a runoff ditch. Going right down through there.
You always look up when you, always.
There's some breaking in the freaking tee, golf tee.
Four.
Always look up to the. See, yeah, nothing. If anything went through there, it was a while ago. All right, so we're proceeding up this trail, checking everything out. Tracks and everything here. All
that track, dude? Yeah, right here. How that comes down, that's interesting. And right here. It looks going right out that way, possibly. Yeah, that's like open up right up in there. So folks, what we're doing is we're looking for tracks. I'm gonna put this camera up here as we walk up through. Looking around. Smells like oh yeah, that smells like wet dog. Smell like wet dog.
That could be if you look right there from this rock over, it looks like the metatarsal break. So that could be a
print. This here, to where it goes like this. Yeah. Heading out that way. Going right down that big bank there. Almost right in line with. Getting this going here. Alright, so the camera's set. Now we're just walking down this road here. Hopefully we get some activity. So when we go down this road, we're gonna do some calls. See if we get any responses back. And go from there.
That's a rover and a frog.
Alright, so folks. Sometimes people say, you know, don't make all kinds of noise, all this stuff like that. Well, nothing's going to happen sometimes, you know, if you don't draw attention to yourself. So you have to do stuff like making calls and banging and all this stuff. Even bring music out or something. It's important to draw attention to yourself. Because if not, your chances of coming in contact's pretty slim. It's just a word of advice. Devin's good. You could do a call. Devin's gonna do a call. open. Sighting, or not sighting, but activity was up around the corner. I really truly think rocks, right? This is the infamous spot. Yep.
Ooh, look at the trail.
Look at that.
Dead ran off through there.
Haha. Wow. Look at that. It's not done by anything big, though. But it looks like it's coming over here. Like it goes right in through here and try to bomb down through there. Could be definitely a deer. Yeah, this is it. This is a spot. Yeah, if we could do the, if you could do those rock clocks, dude, see what we get on them. Hey, do you want to put your tripod on this and put this over here? Cause, or no? You know what I mean? So we could display both of us.
If you want. You don't have to.
There you go. There you go. Okay, so we think we got something thrown at us, but I wasn't sure. Yeah, I heard it come through the trees. So I'm going to set this up over here. Nice. Something down there.
That's a skunk.
Brought something to us.
Keep that light on, keep that light on. I don't know what that is, and I don't really want to screw with it. Right now, guys, we have something moving off.
Right behind us, just like that meter said. That meter said there was something behind us. I don't trust those meters either. I think they're stupid sometimes, but that was definitely.
Yeah, left something to be desired.
It's definitely done to be desired.
See now, you could zoom this in too by pushing that in and out. This right here, you just gotta pull it out, yep, like that. Yeah, I'm seeing
that. I heard that. I mean, it sounded like an animal, like a four-legged, you know.
Yeah.
But so that thing actually said it was right behind us.
This thing was a coyote.
People say it works. Everybody on here that questions it, it works. Creatures out here right now are forest creatures, just regular forest creatures, just animals. Well, the sound that was thrown at us could have been, I'm not saying it was, but it could have been definitely a rock, or it could have been also tree nuts. But this was literally distinctive coming forward. And when it was coming forward, it was thrown, and or the wind was blowing up, but there's no wind. So that was an interesting sound. So, the verdict is, the squatches, I think, are still here, but they're very, very cautious and quiet, and they're not going to come any closer than whatever they're doing right now. It could be
could be several different reasons. It could be cold, it could be, or not cold, but it could be because it's so quiet that we'll hear them, or whatever. But truthfully, I don't think there's anything, you know, distinctive right now that's right next to us, unless something happens. So, we're gonna call it from this location because of the certain back raise. I'm using nothing moving. Nothing. We did tree knocks, we did whistles, we did tree, we did rock clacks, we did absolutely everything that we possibly could do. Just nothing. You know, and I mean, what do you think, Devin? Put the camera on you and see what you...
I think the area is pretty much dead. It's because there's not really much of a food source here. It's more of an oil lease, and there's people come up here all the time. And it's more of a compromise. Oh, I'm going to come out here to get food, and then I'm going to get caught.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to get seen. I'm not going to come out closer.
Yeah.
I'm going to stay further away.
Right, but they still are, I truly believe, around.
Right? They're still truly around. They're just not going to come closer.
Yeah.
Because of that fact.
So that's all we'll basically get. It's probably just these little pops, these little movements, little this.
Yeah. Well, it's something. It's just not anything exciting.
Exciting!
Yeah. Well, it's still exciting, but it's not as exciting. Because we're used to getting trees pushed over.
Yes.
Loud knocks and stuff. But it's still good to know that there's a squatch still around.
Yeah.
That's the good point. Mm-hmm. There's something still here.
So we're just going to head out right now and, just call it because of the lack of activity. I mean, it's dead, like literally. It could be because of the summer, the way the summer. We'll be back up in the fall. We'll check it out in the fall, see what we get in the fall. But right now, But it was a good expedition. We heard a few noises here and there. And I'm not saying that there was no activity whatsoever, but it was down to nothing. So, that's it for expedition number 55, guys. And we're just gonna get out of here and check some other stuff out. And woohoo! Bye bye, then. And keep it squatchy!
Right? Right, Devin?
Keep it squatchy, keep it real.